In week 8 of the NFL, the 4-2 New York Jets came to town to take on the 3-3 Oakland Raiders. The Raiders are going to be without their starting quarterback Derek Carr as he's out with a broken thumb. Highlights coming up next.
Everything changes.
So the Jets coming into this game after falling to the New England Patriots last episode, they're going to try and turn things around today against one of the worst offenses in the NFL. So we'll see if the Jets can turn things around and get their season back on track though. But the second play of the game is not going to go their way. Roy Helu going to take that one to the house, 55 yards and into the end zone for the touchdown. So the Jets, who struggled last week trying to stop the New England Patriots, all of a sudden maybe they're in a little bit of a slump. I don't know. Now they're playing one of the worst teams in the NFL. And the Raiders just went 55 yards untouched into the end zone. So the Jets quickly got to have to find a way to turn things around as they're back on offense now. 3rd and 5, Ryan Fitzpatrick throwing it over to Eric Decker. He's going to make the catch as he's down to the 42-yard line. So the Jets looking to try and march down this field, tie this game up now. Maybe that first drive was a fluke. Who knows? But Ryan Fitzpatrick throwing it over the middle of the field, and it is intercepted. That's been a problem with Ryan Fitzpatrick all season long. He's been throwing way too many turnovers. He has about 10 interceptions already on the season and only like 6 touchdowns. So something has to change with him very quickly if they want to try to get into the postseason. So now that's going to be Matt McGloin starting for the Raiders today since Derek Carr is injured with a broken thumb. Roy Helu going to take that one into the end zone once again for his second touchdown of the day. And it is now 14-0 Oakland Raiders over the New York Jets. So the Jets, all of a sudden, they found themselves losing to the Patriots last episode, and now they find themselves under in the first quarter still. They're down 14-0, so they got to turn things around very quickly if they want to get back into this game and hopefully turn their season around, because right now they're at 4-2, and they got to keep up with the Miami Dolphins as well. So a nice drive coming here as Ryan Fitzpatrick is going to find Kellen Davis down to the 20-yard line as we're running low to the last play of the first quarter. We move ahead to the second quarter now. It is 1st and goal. Fitzpatrick going to drop back, throwing it over the middle of the field, over to Brandon Marshall, and he's going to make the catch, and the Jets are on the board for the first time today, so they cut the lead in half now. It is 14-7. Jets with the ball right once again as soon as the Raiders go 3 and out. So Fitzpatrick looking down the field, going deep over the middle of the field. That is Jeremy Curley. He's going to make the catch and go into Raiders territory, and they're marching down the field again. Can the Jets find a way to tie this game up? They've been playing very well on offense so far. They just got to limit those turnovers. So it is now 2nd and 10. Fitzpatrick looking for a receiver, throwing it over to the left side of the field, overthrowing his man, and intercepted once again. So Ryan Fitzpatrick, another interception from him, and things really got to turn around really quickly. He's in the beginning of the season, it was all Fitzmagic. It was a bunch of touchdowns, really great drives, and then all of a sudden, the last couple of games, it's been Fitztragic, where he's been throwing a lot of interceptions, a lot of turnovers, and throwing away a lot of games for the Jets. So now they trail 14-7. Fortunately, the Jets defense is keeping them in the game, going to limit them to going 3 and out once again. And Fitzpatrick going down the field once again, trying to get the Jets back into this game with about 2 minutes left to play in the half. And then we're going to see if the Jets can march down the field. So there's now 51 seconds left. Fitzpatrick throwing it over the middle of the field. That's Jeremy Curley once again. The Jets are now in the red zone, down to the 17-yard line. Can the Jets find a way to punch that one into the end zone, tie this game before halftime? They do get the ball in the second half. So it's now 20 seconds left, throwing it over the middle of the field. His intended receiver was Eric Decker. And once again, Ryan Fitzpatrick throwing his 3rd interception of the first half. So the Jets really struggling with the turnovers this season now, as they were denied twice in the last couple of minutes of the half of a touchdown to tie this game. So at halftime, the Jets are trailing 14-7 as we move ahead to the second half. So now Geno Smith coming into the game, and we had to make the change. Fitzpatrick was just struggling way too much, so it's now Geno Smith time. Once again, going to try to get them back into this lead, throwing it over to Jeff Cumberland. He's going to make the catch, and he is down to the 12-yard line. So Geno Smith coming right into this game, 2 for 2, and marching the Jets right down the field. Can they get into the end zone? They're going to be it's going to be a play action. Smith looking for a receiver, throwing it over the middle of the field. That is Devin Smith in the end zone for the touchdown. So the Jets do end up tying this game as Geno Smith is going to drive the Jets right back down the field. And that's one thing the Jets need to fix. They got to fix those turnovers very quickly. So the Raiders right back to work. Matt McGloin looking for a receiver. He's scrambling outside the pocket. He's picking up the first down with his legs, and he's going to get down to about the 22-yard line. And the Jets have to find a big stop right here. They got to make that stop to stop the Raiders from getting into the end zone. So it is now 2nd and 1. McGloin, play action, looking for a receiver, throwing it in the end zone, and he's going to find behind Michael Crabtree for the touchdown, and the Jets defense gives up the touchdown and the lead once again. And Cromartie and Crabtree are going to have some words after the play, but now it is time for the Jets. Geno Smith trying to find a way to get the Jets back into this game, and he is going to make the same exact mistake that Ryan Fitzpatrick has been doing all season long, throwing a crucial interception when the Jets are trying to drive down the field to tie the game up. So that is now the fourth turnover on the day for the New York Jets. Things are not looking too good for them. And guys, they're playing one of the worst offenses in the NFL. This is the 32 ranked offense in the NFL, and they have given up 301 yards on the day so far to this team, and that is pretty embarrassing. As you're one of the best defenses in the NFL, you're going to give up another touchdown right there. That's going to make it a two-possession game here, when that will be it here from Oakland, as the Jets are going to fall once again to the Oakland Raiders by a final score of 31-21. The Jets do get back on the board with another touchdown, but it was not enough to get the Jets back in this game. So unfortunately, the Jets are going to fall once again. They fall to 4-3 on the season now, and the Raiders will improve to 4-3 as well. So what do we got, guys? What do we do? Ryan Fitzpatrick really struggling. Three more interceptions today. And Geno Smith did throw an interception as well. So do we go to Geno Smith now, guys? I think it might be time to call on Geno Smith. Fitzpatrick really has been struggling so far. So the Jets' next opponent is going to be at MetLife Stadium against the Jacksonville Jaguars. They are 1-6. So if the Jets lose this game, I don't really have much faith for them for the rest of the season. So hopefully they can pick up another win next episode. If you guys did enjoy the video, make sure you guys drop a like. And if you're new to the channel, make sure you guys subscribe. I will catch you guys in week 9.